Tonight, on our first episode, we travel to Durty Nellys on University Avenue, Gainesville's premier Irish pub. Sam doesn't know what to do. I have myself poured a Bass Ale, a crisp, refreshing, and smooth English ale. Its simplicity goes well with a Lou from Alumine, whose simplistic punk has brought me hours of enjoyment. I'm Graham Johnson, and this is Bards in Bars Getting Beer.
Hello, this is Graham Johnson here at Level to the Room. We are at Durty Nellys here with Lou from Alumine. And we're here to discuss the brand new self-titled album that was just released yesterday. For starters, man, how are you feeling about it?
I'm feeling pretty good. It's been a long time. We've had it done for like a really, really long time. And I mean, the anticipation kind of subsided really quick because we just like, people have been hearing it from us. It's been cool to see like it build up and stuff. I'm glad it's out, honestly.
What took us so long? Was it just a...
Just like making sure that we like did the right thing to get the right amount of press and like trying to get on like Whelmed and stuff like that. Like we weren't on Whelmed before we recorded it. That was like all after stuff, yeah. So it was just that, just making sure that we did justice to the release.
It's kind of taking the steps necessary to push it out where it needs to be.
That's always been like a part of the band. It's like every step has to sort of be like well thought out. This isn't like my first band. It's not like Pedro or anybody else's first band. So you know, it's like if you want to take it seriously, you have to take it seriously and like plan things out, do things like accordingly, and things like that. So that was really why it took so long. It's been done since like October, like 6 months ago. Yeah.
Wow, man. Honestly, that's really cool that you took the time to make sure that it was going to be a good release, you know, to make sure that the right people were going to hear it, because that really does mean a lot. I mean, you could have the greatest album on the face of the planet, if the right person isn't hearing it, what's the point? You
know? Right, right, right.
But I mean, it definitely came out really, really well.
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, what kind of equipment were you using when you recorded it? You said you recorded it before the Whelmed Records deal, right?
Yeah, I mean, we went to Rob in Golden Tones, and I mean, he just recorded all of it. We used his stuff too, actually. We used his like amps and shit like that. My guitar was like out of a JCM 900.
Oh wow!
It was just like a really cheesy rock guitar, but it worked. I forgot what Lauren was playing out of, but yeah, we used all of his equipment, and then except the drums. No, even the drums, yeah. We use all this equipment. And Rob then, like, mixed and mastered it. And, like, yeah, I mean, it's been, the way it sounds right now is the way it sounded when I sent it to Lauren. And it's the way it sounded the last day that we recorded with Rob.
So this is as pure as it gets.
That's, like, literally what it is. Like, it's been this recording that is out right now is the same recordings that Rob handed over to us the last day that we recorded with him, like October 20th or something like that. And it's the same, this like same EP I sent to like Whelmed, and I was like, look, it's done, like here it is, do you want to put it out? And they were like, yes. And then it's sort of how it came out. Candace had to do with it a little bit, I heard, but yeah, it ended up working out.
Of the four songs, though, what all had been written for a while, and like what was written specifically before this EP or this album dropped, rather.
The first song I wrote for the EP is the second song, Comenzamos, and Comenzamos means like we're starting in Spanish, and like that's why I named it that. That was like the first song that I wrote. It was like January of last year or something, December of last year that I wrote that song. December of last year.
And that was specifically for Alumine?
No, I was like in between. I was like, I didn't have a band, and like I sort of just wrote that song because I was like dealing with stuff. And I remember like when I wrote that song, I was like, this would be a good song to like play with a band. I wrote it like just acoustically. And that's like something that I do a lot, is I write songs like on acoustic first to see if they're like strong as like solo songs. And I wrote it, and it was really, really good. I got really good feedback from like my really close friends. And you know, when I like hooked up with Pedro, it was like that was like one of the first songs that we tried doing. But the fourth song that's on there, like Alumine, that song was like a sluggish song before, which is like a band that I used to be in. It was a sluggish song, but with different lyrics and like a little bit of a different structure. Like there was one less part in it maybe. And but it was like a really good riff, and I loved that riff. And like just that verse and stuff, I thought it sounded really good. And so I like rewrote the lyrics to it to like reflect like something that I was dealing with. And it was just like a lot better. And I was really happy to be able to use it for like Alumine. And it's funny because V, it's not like the same thing, but like when V used to play the breaker with V, and then V now plays the breaker with Gutless. So it felt like my version of that. And so that was cool. I mean, it sounds better now than it did with Gutless. But so that's the only song, and that was written like, that song I had written with Sluggish like 2013.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, 2014 maybe. It's like the only song that's that old. The other one, Lele, that song was, we wrote that song like maybe, we had finished that song maybe 2 or 3 weeks before we recorded it. And then Value was like written kind of when the band first started.
And see, that's interesting because it's listening to the album, Lele sounds like it's been around for a while.
It's just the most, honestly, Lele's cool because it's definitely a good reflection of like what the band sounds like. Because like it's like a mixture of like, honestly, it's basically like if you took like Comenzamos and Value and put them in one song, it kind of sounds like Lele. Because it has like that middle part that's like really simple, like regular punk rock, and the chorus too is like very simple regular punk rock, but then that like intro part is like a little technical.
Sure.
And like Value is like very straightforward the whole time. That's like my whole, that's like a simple ass song though, just because.
Oh,
so,
I love it, man.
Yeah. Well, so I like Lele a lot because I feel like it's a good reflection of what the band sounds like. Even our new songs, they sound a lot more like Lele than they do like Value or Coming Sound Like.
Definitely when listening to Lele, you know, like because of that sort of almost mathy intro, you know, you've got, you know, like a very simple 4/4 to a very slow 4/4 to just cut time. And then, you know, you do that a couple of times, and then it's just like, okay, now it's just regular driving again.
Yeah.
You know, and then you drop back into it without missing a beat. And it's fantastic, man. And then to go from a song like that to again Value, you know, to where it's like
very straightforward.
God, what is that song like? Not even 2 minutes long.
Yeah.
Right?
Most, I mean, I think our longest song is the last song that on the EP is really long. It's like 4 minutes or something. It's the longest song I have. Like no other song. Every other song is like 3 minutes or less usually. Just like a lot of parts in it, a lot of changes. I try to make it intense, so it feels like it's like the same sensation I had when I listened to like Joyce Manor's self-titled EP, where I was like, wow, this feels so intense, and it's like, but the whole thing is only like 20 minutes.
Oh yeah,
you know?
I have to agree with you.
Yeah,
on that,
so that's, I mean, that's 100% what I'm ripping off when I like make songs really short.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with that, man. It's kind of like
it's
huge,
so subconscious at this point.
But it's a huge impact too. Yeah. Just like the Joyce Manor self-titled, you have every song is a different emotion and almost experienced as intensely and fleeting as a as an emotion.
Yeah.
You know,
oh,
it's
God.
Just there and then it's gone, and you're just like,
yeah.
What
we,
was that?
We have lots of math rock influences. The thing is that like I'm not really good at playing math rock, but I figured out, I don't know, it's like a nice, I guess what I love about math rock is the time changes and like the swelling of like emotions and stuff like that, and like the feeling of the song. So I just like try to do that a lot, and then like sometimes I write songs and I think like what's like the most dramatic time change I can do right now, and then I just like go for that. And like I find myself trying to make things like even slower every time, or even like chunkier. So like we have like a new EP ready to go almost, and a lot of the songs are like really refined. I feel like it sounds even more like Illuminati than this first EP, you know. And this first EP is awesome, but it's like our first stuff. And I, you know, I always feel like, you know, a band's second, third stuff is more like what they are. The first one is just sort of like getting your feet on the ground.
Right,
you know?
Need time as a band to play together and sort of like
refine a sound.
Right, meld into each other.
And that's why Lele is so good, and I like that people like it a lot, because like that song is like, that's the last song I wrote before we started recording. So it was like the closest to, yeah, it's like the closest to what we end up sounding like.
The fuck? What are you drinking?
I don't want to say.
Fair enough.
I definitely don't want to say, because I don't endorse it at all.
I personally am drinking Bass.
Cool. I bet me telling you I don't want to say what it is, you can probably figure out what it is, maybe.
I have an idea.
Okay. I can whisper in your ear. You want me to whisper in your ear? I don't fuck with that shit. I don't know. I get it because it's like I'm so used to it, but like I'm definitely trying not to drink. It's like my go-to easy beer because it's like it tastes so watery.
Easy. Are you kidding me? And then it's like.
But they fucked up.
How can I do this without giving it away? But like, scream!
Yeah. Yeah. But they fucked up.
Oh man.
Whatever.
All right. So. Granted, this isn't your first band, but I'm sure that you bring, like, stylings with you from every band that you've been in, because you have your own sound, you have your own way of playing guitar, your own way of singing, definitely your own way of singing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what inspires you to, obviously, we know we have the Joyce Manor out there,
yeah.
But what else, man? Like, what are some of your deepest, like, oldest inspirations from, like, when you were a kid?
I started writing music because I was like 13, I was like 12. I started playing guitar when I was like 12, but I was just playing whatever. But the first band I remember like getting really like disgustingly like obsessively into was Nirvana. And I was like reading Kurt Cobain's biographies and like all this shit. And like listening to Nirvana is like what made me want to write music, because like it was so easy to play and like I thought the lyrics were so cool, and it was like I was like an angsty little like 13, 12 year old kid. And that's like one of the big things that I got into. And then like through Nirvana I got into like the Pixies, which was like another huge, huge influence of mine. And like Weezer. And I also did a lot, like in high school I got really into like musical theater. And I also like did jazz band and stuff. So like later in life I really like started to take like a lot of influences. I really like a lot of different kinds of music, and I kind of see it as like an art form, and so it's like I'm really into like a lot of stuff, you know. There's nothing that I'll ever like reject up front at all, because I feel like everything kind of like deserves its opportunity, you know. And also I feel like everybody's music and art is like valuable in some sense, you know, and I think that's really important. And like, yeah, I think like when people tell me that they don't listen to like specific genres of music, that sounds so like asshole, yeah. Like pretentious to me, where it's like, are you gonna just like brush off an entire like genre of music, like an entire form of art? That's like saying like you don't like abstract art, like,
yeah,
you don't look at any abstract art. It's like, okay, all right buddy, good for you. That's how I feel about it, honestly.
That's not a bad way to look at it.
But yeah, I mean, and I've learned also a lot over time to like hone in on the things that I listen to and what I like about it, you know? So I try to like dissect anything that I'm really into, and I try to dissect like what is it about it that I like, and then like I sometimes maybe like it becomes a part of my subconscious, and like I try to implement that in a lot of ways. Because I feel like there's something to take from like everything, you know? Like jazz music is amazing, there's like plenty of things that are going on there that like should be considered, you know? And just like in everything, like, all kinds of music, pop music, like country music.
An answer befitting only a true musician. I listen to everything. Therefore.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's awesome, man. And that's honestly definitely the answer I would want to hear from you. Like specifically.
Thanks.
So I guess what we come to now is what's the goal? What's the big, like, long-term goal for Alumine?
I don't know. That's a
really... I know that's the hard one.
Yeah. I honestly just want to rock. I really don't know what to tell you.
Oh, my God.
I just want to go... I just want to play a bunch of places and meet a bunch of people. And I want to just, like, become involved in the scene and stuff like that. I feel like we're cool and... We make decent music, and like I'd love to connect with a lot of people in a lot of different places, because that's really just my goal for the most part. I'd love to be on tour like all the time if I could be.
So it's about time. I think we've discussed everything we need to discuss. To wrap it up, though, I mean, is there anything that you want to say? I mean, this is going out to all of Gainesville. It's not a very big location, but if there's anything you want to say to the scene that follows you, I mean, what would it be?
Go listen to other people's bands. Go to the gig. Do you want to name new bands? Go listen to Winded. Go listen to Cooper. Go listen to Rosemary Kennedy. go listen to Quimbley, go listen to Kindergarten Cop, go listen to Woolbright, go listen to Insignificant Other, go listen to Night Witch, go listen to a bunch of other people. I'm sorry if I missed you. I love you. But yeah, do that. Also, don't come. I keep saying this because this shit keeps happening. Don't come to my show if you know that you shouldn't be there. That's odd. That's like people. I feel like I have like enough of a reputation where like if people know that they're like not gonna like me or something, like just don't come. I'm almost at the point of like just straight up kicking people out because like I can't deal with it. I can't. So that's all I have to say. And everyone else feels the same way. Every band I just mentioned feels the same way. Like if you're an asshole, do not come to the gig.
Finally. What does everyone need to know about this new record? Where are we going to find it?
It's on Bandcamp and all the major streaming devices. All the major streamers that I can think of right now. Like Spotify, Apple Music, all of those. I know it's going to be on YouTube soon. And yeah, just find it there. Bandcamp would be the best way to go. Check out Whelmed Records and all the other bands.
Yeah. Hear that, Apple users? You can get it on Apple Music. It's gonna be real easy to get. You get on your iPhone, pull it up, download it. $3.
It's $3 on Bandcamp.
$3 on Bandcamp on Apple Music.
If you have like an Apple Music subscription, you can just listen to it for free. Yeah. It's like Spotify.
Hey, you can listen to it with your subscription for free.
Yeah,
it's not like just you can on Spotify. Yeah.
Yeah. And we'll have physical releases soon.
Just basically, the point is listen to the record. It's fantastic. Alu's fantastic. The rest of the band is fantastic. If you ever catch them.
Thank you.